was the worst day in his life, yet he said, if you are not speaking with, you see how unique is this relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? When he said, if you are not angry with me, I don't care. Okay? When we have our relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, don't care about the others, you know. When you don't have your relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you don't have your dhikr with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam used, whenever he has a problem or disaster or a very critical position, what did he used to do? And you know the life of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam? He had a lot of those matters in his life. What did he used to do? He start prayer. He start prayer. Pray to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And he's going to feel the relief in his prayer to Allah. Why? Because he has this unique relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and then he doesn't care about the others. Okay? Even though, don't misunderstand me, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam fixed all matters of his life the best according to his time and to his whatever available in his time, you know. But yet, all of these matters that he fixed is only as a practice. But in his heart, he did not rely on anyone except Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. When you look at the companion, you are going to find the same story. And that's why, out of their trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, will give the favor to the others. And that's why, because of their sacrifice, we honored to get the Holy Quran and the tradition of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And be sure, without their sacrifice, it's not going to happen this to us. And we should be thankful of them, because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, whoever doesn't thank people, he did not thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. I cannot imagine this, you know. When they have bay'at al-aqaba with the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, what was their number? They were 73. They were 73 persons. And Hajj at that time, I cannot imagine Hajj less than thousands of people. For sure they have thousands of Arab, you know, performing Hajj during bay'at al-aqaba. And those 73 persons, they told him, O Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, if you command us to fight against these people now, we are ready. They are ready? Yes, yes, they are ready. 73 in front of thousands of people, of the Hajj. And they want to fight against them. Why? Because this confidence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam spread over to them. This confidence of Allah in Sayyidina Ibrahim, it spread to his wife or to his lady and to his son, you know. And that's why she told him, go away, go. Don't worry. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to raise us. And that's what we need. How to gain confidence in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? We should know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We feel that we know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, but in the reality we don't know Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We should have better knowledge than Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm telling you, nowadays you hardly find anyone speaking about knowledge of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They speak about Islamic sciences, you know, they speak about fiqh, they speak about everything, you know, but they tend to forget to speak about the knowledge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And how to get the knowledge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The best way to recite Quran. Okay, why? Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَنَا جَلِيسُ مَنْ ذَكَرَ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, sit and attain the one who make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If this dhikr is by Quran, that means you are speaking with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, not in your world. The one who has this relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, do you think that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is going to waste him or not to let him know much more? That's why when you read in Quran, whatever you are reading about marriage, about contract, about a deal, about renting, about whatever, you are going to find that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala ends the verse by saying Inna Allah Ghafoorun Rahim or Inna Allah Azizun Hakim, just to make you more knowledgeable of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And I'm telling you, Muslim in general nowadays, they don't have the relation that they should have with the Quran. And this is, I think, the beginning. If you want to have good relation with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, this scratching point or the first point should be to have your good relations with the Quran al-Kareem. And all of us, not excused, even if we are non-Arabic speaker. I'm telling you, even the Arabic speaker, they don't have the good relations, the stronger relations with the Quran al-Kareem. We should have much more stronger relation with Allah. Try, work hard. You are going to find yourself, you have the ability to start reading. Try to teach your minors, your youngsters, try to teach them Quran al-Kareem and make them love the Quran al-Kareem and sit with the Quran al-Kareem, because this is the best way to gain knowledge in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And whenever you gain